Blessed Sunday to you, Doane Baptist Church, and our friends who might be watching with us in this online service. Now, we know that these are challenging times for some people, although some of us are already worshiping physically in church, but whether virtually or physically, I hope that you are blessed, that you know that you're blessed, and that you feel blessed as we worship God this morning. Now, allow me to read from Psalm 134, verses 1 to 3 for our scripture reading. Behold, bless ye the Lord, all ye servants of the Lord, which by night stand in the house of the Lord. Lift up your hands in the sanctuary and bless the Lord that made heaven and earth, bless thee out of Zion. Let's pray. Father, many times we long for you, for your presence, for your assurances when we are down, when we are weak. But Lord, remind us again of just who we are before a holy and righteous God. Who are we to demand for your presence, O Lord? Who are we to demand to ask for your blessings? For we are but dust, and worse, we are rebellious dust. And yet, Lord, you have given us the best that you can give, Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son, in whom, Lord, we have your presence inside each of us by your Holy Spirit. So, Lord, humble us as we approach you and as we worship you this morning. Humble us. Remind us that we are but sinners who have received grace from our Creator. Have mercy on your people. Bless us. And may our worship be acceptable in your sight. Cleanse us from all filthy thoughts, all distracting thoughts, and just help us to give you the best of our mind and our attention this morning. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Bow down before him, his glory proclaim. With gold of obedience and incense of love,
God has given us a new name. By saving us, we became his children. Let us sing this song, A New Name in Glory. Ready? Sing.
I was once a sinner, but I came pardon to receive from my Lord. This was freely given, and I found and he always kept his word. There's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, oh yes, it's mine. And a white robe angel sing the story. A sinner has come home, for there's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, oh yes, it's mine. was humbly kneeling at the cross, fearing not but God's every frown. When the heavens opened and I saw that my name was written down, there's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, oh yes, it's mine. And the white robe angels sing the story, a sinner has come home. For there's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, oh yes, it's mine. With my sins forgiven, I am bound for heaven, nevermore to roam. In the book 'tis written, saved by grace, oh, the joy that came to my soul. Now I am forgiven, and I know, by the blood I am made whole. There's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, and it's mine, yes, it's mine, yes, it's mine. And the white robe angels sing the story, a sinner has come home. For there's a new name written down in glory, and it's mine, yes, it's mine, yes, it's mine. With my sins forgiven, I am bound for heaven, nevermore to roam.
Not just to serve, but to love God with all our heart. Let us sing this song, A Passion for Thee. Ready? Say,
set my heart, O dear Father, for Thee and Thee only. Give me a thirst for Thy presence divine. Lord, keep my focus on loving Thee. Turn my heart after Thine, a passion for Thee, O Lord, set a fire in my soul, and a thirst for my God. Hear Thou my prayer, Lord, Thy power impart, not just to serve, but to love.
Things that God has done to us. A simple thank you might not be enough, but it would be a reminder of our gratitude to Him. Let us sing, Thank You, Jesus. Ready? Say,
Thank You, Jesus, for all. Thank you, Lord.
Good morning, Kag Mayngaga. Welcome to Doane Baptist Church Sunday Service Online. And salamat sa Ginoo sa sininga-aga nga kita sa gihapon padayon sa aton nga panimbahon. And maulan-ulan naman ang aton nga tiyempo subong sa nagligan nga Domingo, amuman natabo sang hapon. And ang bagyo and then subong mera naman coming. Gani halong nanggit kita mga utod sa Ginoo sa gihapon. Kita kung may ginabatsyag na nga daan, ubo kag sipon, likaw na lang kita magwaanay or magkato sa mga dako nga pagtiripon or damo nga mga tao or coming to church. Kabay pa sa sininga aga, yara lang kamo sa mga mga kahimtangan, tagsa-tagsang iban, magubugtaw ng iban, nakapulupangaping iban, nakapamahaw ng iban, nagapangimos na inugpanyaga. And salamat gid sa Diyos sa inyong mga kauturan nga nagapadala sang bulig kag support diri sa Doane Baptist Church. Sa din man ka mga parte sa kalibutan, diri sa may Pilipinas, Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, bilog nga siyudad, Iloilo City. And salamat gid sa inyo, iban, purposely nagapadalagid, nagkakadto sa diri sa simbahan sa paghulog sa ilang offering, kag support diri sa Doane Baptist Church. Kabay pang Ginoo magpakamayo gid sa inyo, kag sa inyong pamilya, kag sa inyong pagpangabuhi. Sa gyapon mga utod sa Ginoo, hindi kita magkakalipat, maskin pa nga sa kundiin, maayo na ang levels ng status natin diri sa Iloilo City. In the past weeks, nag-drop na sa below 100 ang nag-positive. Nevertheless, hindi kita magpakampanti to remember our health protocols. Face masks, face shields, wash our hands as often as we can, maintain our physical and social distancing. And as much as possible, kaon kita sang maayo gid, eat healthy foods, mga preska nga utanon, ang prutas, kag bismo man sa kundin, exercise kita, do some things that will make you productive. Nga hindi lang gid pabilin sa sedentary lifestyle. And then, salamat sa Diyos sa kundin, ikaw kag akong iban sa aton, are already vaccinated. And there is sa Iloilo City, nakasubra na kita tunga sa herd immunity. And kabay pa, padayon kita mga utol sa Ginoo. Again, it is my choice. It was my choice to be vaccinated. And some other people, wala pa yan naka-decide. Gani sa gihapon, pangamuyo kita. Si kita, God's guidance upon this. Kung sa sininga pamaagi, makapahaganhagan sa sininigahan na buo sa palibot natin, why not? So, you pray about it and you seek God's guidance. And as much as possible, we want to be positive in our outlook sa kabuhi. In spite ng naghanabo sa kabuhi natin, hindi kita magkakalipat. And mga utol sa Ginoo, mumanang akong ginapangabay sa aton, sa kundiin, sa din kita magakadto ang pangamuyo gin naton. Nga ikaw ako, gamiton sang Diyos may solusyon sa problema, kay kun hindi kita solusyon sang problema, basi ikaw ako, amo ang problema. And another thing, din naton pagkalimtan sa pagpangamuyo sa isa kag isa, nagsugod naman ang election na. Together way, yung ibang sa aton siguro personally nakapa, ano na, register sa Ilacaw Galingon sa COMELEC. Ako amuman, and salamat sa Ginoo sa mga tao nga ginamit sang Diyos nga magbulig man sa amon. And sa sininga pamaagi, pangamuyo kita sa aton nasyon, sa aton syudad, sa aton healthcare workers sa gihapon. Sa mga nagakautura na aton nagamalasakit, let's continue to pray for one another. And also pray for Tanalyon family. Nagligad lang October 5, nagtaliwan si Manong Victorino Tanalyon. So let's utod ni siya ni Tita Lil Tanalyon, kilala niyo ang iyang utod nga artist. Okay, so let's pray for Tanalyon family. Schedule ni das ang burial either this coming Friday or Saturday. I will be posting it sa final nila na schedule sa Sininga Merpolis. Meanwhile, sa sini naman nga Sabado, amo ang aton nga special prayer time. So again, sa aton Zoom, special prayer time this coming Saturday, 8 to 9 in the morning. And also, mga utod sa inyong aton nga mga Bible studies, regularly kagang iban pa, let's continue to pray for this and pray also for para sa aton discipleship classes. Nga upcoming, we will be posting this sa aton nga Facebook page, mga utod sa Ginoo. So, pangamuyo lang kita nga sa kundin ma-manage naton ini and then we will post it this particular schedules about iban sa aton maka-attend sini. So stay safe and stay healthy kita. God bless you. God bless us all. Good morning. And God bless you.
carried me along. In my soul I yearned to follow God, but knew I'd never be so strong. I looked out at this world to learn how heaven could be gained. Just to end where I began, where human effort was all in vain. Were it not for grace, I can tell you where I'd be, wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. Battles I would face, forever running, but losing this race, were it not for expressed with all my heart, offered to the friend who took my place and ran a course I could not stop. And when he saw in full just how much his love would cost, he still went the final mile between me and heaven, so I would not be lost. Were it not for grace, tell you where I'd be, wandering down some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. The battles I would face, forever running, but losing this race, were it not for grace. Forever running, but losing this race, were it not for grace.
Mayong aga sa inyo tanan mga kauturan. Nagapasalamat kita sa Ginoo sang sini nga kagayunan naton nga kita makasimba sa sini nga aga diri sa aton nga face to face nga worship, at the same time sa aton nga online. Dako aton pagpasalamat sa Ginoo nga pinaagi sang sini nga mga opportunities both sang aton nga pagtipon as God's people here diri sa aton nga church sa Bonifacio Drive, at the same time nga kamuman dira na nagapamati man sini kag nagabuylog aton nga panimbahon diri sa aton nga online. Kabay pa nga ang Ginoo amugid ang madayaw sa aton nga tunga kag sa gihapon siya magapadayon sa pagpakighambal sa tagsa-tagsa sa aton. Pagabasaon ko ang dinalan sa kasulatan nga kung diin amo ang aton nga pag tun-an sa sini nga aga diri sa Psalm 46 verse 10. Ang pulong sa Ginoo naghambal sa Psalm 46 verse 10, "Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth." Be still and know that I am God. Magapangamuyo kita sa pagpadayo naton sa pagpamalandong sa pulong sa Ginoo. Ginoo, salamat gid sa sini nga aga. Ginatagan mo kami sang sini nga bag-o Ginoo nga adlaw. Kay gayon na naman Ginoo nga magalantaw kami sa imos, kag mamati Ginoo sang imo Ginoo nga tingog para Ginoo sa amon. Buligi Ginoo ang tagsa-tagsa. Kabay pa Ginoo nga sa gihapon ikaw magpakighambal sa amon sa paagi Ginoo nga kung diin ini kinahanglano namon sa adlaw-adlaw nga tanan. Indeed, O Lord, your mercies, kung paano ikaw Ginoo nagalabot sa amon, sa imo Ginoo nga kaluoy, sa imo nga bugay, sa imo nga pagpakamayo. Even Lord, for our spiritual daily needs. Indeed, they're new every morning. So Ginoo, kabay pa nga sa sining nga pagtuon namon sa mga pulong sa liwat, ikaw Ginoo ang magpakamaayo. Maghatag sang kusog kabakod sa amon na mga espirituhanon nga kabuhi. Kagabay pa Ginoo, makakuha naman kami liwat sang pagkaon sa amon mga kalag. Updi kagbuligi Ginoong imong alagad ni Ginoong amon nga ginapangamuyo sa ngalan ni Jesus. Amen. Sa sining aga, pagatunan naton ang isa sa pinaka-familiar na verse na kung diin ayhan sa kadamo sa aton, labi na gid sa sining pandemic, ininangin na aton nga mga pagpamalandong o kung ang pag-remind sa aton sa Ginoo. Labi na gid ayhan sa tion sang salasala, sa tion nga daw ma-panic attack kita, the Lord is always making us understand that we are going to be still. Because in being still, we would know who God is. Be still and know that I am God. Now, diri bala naton makita ang pagkaimportansya sa pulong sa Ginoo. Damo-damo ng mga voices ang aton nga nagakabatian sa adlaw-adlaw nga tanan. Kag sino bala ang aton nga ginapamatian? With all of the voices that we hear every single day, every single time, especially sa sining nga social media, we realize that we could hear all kinds of voices. Kag kunsa aga amuna ang aton dayon nga unahon, na crump na ang aton nga mga pangunauna sa kun ano man dira nga mga news. Either it could be political, either it could be about the pandemic, either it could be about anything. Mga kauturan, maayo gid, matamis gid nga dapat aton pamatian ang pulong sang Ginoo, ang tingog sa Ginoo. Every time we wake up or before kita magadto sa aton nga pagpahuway sa gabi, kag throughout the day, may indeed this would be the meditation of our hearts and of our minds. Kay kun sino, kag kun ano ang aton nga ginapamatian, in one way or the other, amo man na siya ang mag-influence sa aton. Kun ano ina, ayhan ang madala sinaiya sa aton. Ano ang nagakos ang fear, anxiousness, worry, doubts, or even sometimes overthinking that would push us sa sinaabalatsyagon sang uncertainties? Ang pamangkot, sino ang aton nga ginapamatian? Now, nagapatigid kita nga kinahanglan gid naton, we could hear the voice of God, we could hear the word of God regularly and constantly to give us strength, to give us courage, to increase our faith, and also that we could see life, we could say things, halin sa perspective sa Ginoo. Kag luyag ko nga sa sining nga aga, amoy nang paghimuon naton, labi na gid sa sining nga dinalan nga pinaka familiar. Kag ang iban, kung wain nyo pa ini na memorize, kabay pa nga amoy nang sulit-sulito naton throughout the day, kung daw nagasako na, kung mga balatsyagon ta, daw nagasala na, ato pangunahuna, nag-overthink na, be still. Be still my soul, be still my soul. This is God's command, be still. Ang second dira, know, recognize that I am God. Now, lantaw naton ang inibala nga mga pululungon. Ano ang buot gid hambalon sang sini nga be still? Now, kung kisa, we have the notion nga ang word nga be still magpahimunong, magpahimuyong. Now, sa original, aton ini nga makita that this word would mean to release, to let go, to surrender. So, diri sa sini nga dinlan sang kasulatan, in verses 1 to 9, he talks about who God is, and then sa verse 10, all of a sudden, God is instructing us. God is instructing the hearers. Ang bahanon ini siya sa verses 1 to 9 nga nagahambal parte sa Ginoo, and yet nag-shift siya dahil sa verse 10 kung naghambal diri, let go. Cease from striving. Release. I-release natin kung ano man ang aton nga ginahoptan dira. Because in doing that, we are going to learn to know who God is. We could learn, we could know, we could recognize that God is God. Our part is to stop fighting, to surrender, to let go, to acknowledge our weakness, our helplessness. Pinaagi sina aton nga maangkon kag aton maintindihan kung ano gid bala ang Dios sa aton nga kabuhi. Now, I don't know if you would find this interesting that we would be studying. The title of our study this morning is Surrender. Let God fight for you. Or stop fighting. Let God do it for you. Now, tam-an ka-athag ang ini nga prinsipyo diri sa pulong sa Ginoo. I know that we are going to balance this when God is going to tell us to work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. But also, there are times when God wants us just to stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, just like what God said to Moses. Sang dawain na sila pakantuan, sang gatubang sila sang Red Sea. Just to stand still. In the same way, sa sining dinalan sang kasulatan, sa sining ambahanon on verse 10, that indeed the hymn writer would infuse the challenge of God sa iya tagipusoon, that God is speaking, stand still. Be still. Let go. Surrender, release. Stop striving. Cease from fighting. And then you would know that I am God. Now I think ang iya sining background will go will give us sang iya pagid sining experience ang sining sining hymn writer. Now if you're going to study some Bible scholars would like to take inisya ang iya sini nga title to the chief musician for the sons of Korah, a song upon Alamoth. So ginamba ini sang mga ano sang ladies choir for the sons to the chief musician for the sons of Korah. Ini sila mga bahin ini sang mga families, Levite families, na kung diin may lain-lain silang assignment sa pag-worship. Kagang ini ang mga sons of Korah, kagang iya sining ang mga descendants, ang family, ang mga descendants ni Korah, ang ilang may-ara sila sang parts ang ilayang family nga ladies choir. Kag-amuni sila ang ginsulat para sa ilang kantahon. Now many of those who have studied this would bring us to the writer sang sining ang bahanon nga amo si King Hezekiah. If you're going to study the book of Psalms, kalabanan sang sining mga salmo ginsulat ni Haring David, but there are also psalms nga ginsulat sa lain nga mga writers like Moses, like Solomon, like King Hezekiah. Kag ini ang Psalm 46 makita naton diri nga people would like to see that this is one of those songs nga gin sulat ni King Hezekiah. Now iya ini nga ginsulat tungod sang isa bala ka experience nga natabo sa kabuhi sa mga tawo sang Ginoo. Nga kung diin after that the Assyrian Empire had already taken captive ang northern part sang Israel. Nga kung diin ato didto ang 10 tribes kag gindala sila didto. Now this is a very cruel and very dreadful makaladlok ini nga klase nga empire. Kang ilang ginahimo sini ginapang conquer nila ang mga siyudad kag mga nasyon. Kag indi lang, but they are also creating so much fear and cruelty. Isagid sa ilang design sini, wain nila ginalubong ang mga nagakalapatay nila ang mga kontra, but rather they put it like a heap, do ginatambak lang nila. Parang gusto nila nga mabalaan kag makitaan sa palibot ng mga banwa man o nasyon that there is really no fight for them. So you either mag-surrender ka o kun amuman ini ang matabo sa inyo. For this very reason, this empire had been feared in the ancient times. Amuna nga ang mga tao nga grabe ang ilang paghigugma, grabe ang ilang nga dumot, grabe ang ilang handom nga makabalos ini tungod ayhan ang ilang mga kilala, mga amigo kun mga kaparentihan nga ginpamatay sang kasubong sini nga mga tao. Then we would understand nga ang si Prophet Jonah, when God wanted to give mercy and second chance para sa mga Ninevites, we could understand why Jonah would run away from the will and the direction of God. Amo ini silang klase. So here, we could find it that in the book of 2 Chronicles, kag makita man nato na sa 2 Kings, kag sa book sang Isaiah, in 2 Chronicles chapter 32, naglabot na ini ang general, si General Sennacherib, nga nagakadto na sila pagkadto dito sa Jerusalem. And they have reached a certain fortified city nga amuya ang before maklabot ka sa Jerusalem, maagi ka anay diri. So they have already taken this city. So nakita na nila nga kung diin ang ining Assyrian army nagamartsa na pagkadto sa Jerusalem, they knew, everybody knew that it only would take time before na makangker ang Jerusalem. Now, many years ago, ini sa modern history na ini, na-excavate nila ang ining Assyrian Empire dito sa Middle East. And they realized that this Assyrian Empire, grabe sila magasulat, especially sa ilang history. Kagang isa sang sining tablet of stone na kung di nila ginsulat ang ilang history, it talks about Jerusalem. Kag dito sa ginsulat, nakabutang na dito that si King Hezekiah and all Jerusalem daw ara sila sa hawla sang pispis. In other words, it would only take time or probably few days or weeks before nga ilaya makangker ang Jerusalem. But then of course, ato nga makita that with the ministry of Isaiah to God's people, but also to the King Hezekiah, gin-encourage niya si King Hezekiah that I have a message from God. God is going to spare Jerusalem. Indi ka mahadlok, tindugigid. So here comes King Hezekiah in Second Chronicles chapter 32 on verse 7 and 8. This is King Hezekiah. Be strong and courageous. Be not afraid nor dismayed for the king of Assyria, nor all the multitude that is with him, for there be more with us than with him. With him is an arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord our God to help us, to fight our battles. And the people rested themselves upon the words of King of Hezekiah, King of Judah. Kanami, sang sining hari, kay even though sa paglantaw, anugid abi kadako ang ining syudad, na kung diin ang ining successful ng mga invaders, ara na dira, pero pinaagi sa pagpasalig sa iyang prophet Isaiah, ginkuha ato, gintuuhan ato sang hari, si King Hezekiah. And then iya ginhambalan ang mga tao, be strong and courageous, be not afraid nor dismayed. With him is the arm of the flesh, but with us is the Lord our God to help us. And the people rested themselves upon the words of Hezekiah, king of Judah. Ka very picturesque bala sini, nga out sang sini nga experience. King Hezekiah would write a song about of who God is. Na sa sini nga tion, wa na sila sang mahimo. Sa sini nga tion, nga kung diin, they just have to rest on God. They have just to release all their anxieties and all their cares and all their fears. They have to surrender to the God who is going to protect them. They have to let go kung anuman ilang mahimo and let God take control of the situation. Surrender to God. And you would know that God is going to fight for you. Cease striving, stop fighting. God would do it for you. Now, after this happened, on verse 10, then said Sennacherib, king of Assyria, whereon do you trust that ye abide in the cities in Jerusalem? Doth not Hezekiah persuade you to give over yourselves to die by famine and by thirst, saying, the Lord our God shall deliver us out of the hand of the king of Assyria? So here comes sagwa sang ilayang ano sagwa sang ilayang nga pader nga ginahambal sa ila, ginasinggit sa ila. In other words, there is now something nga ginaterrorize na the inhabitants of a Jerusalem. Anong ginahambal sang hari niyo? Saligan niyo ang inyong nga Dios, amo ni magsalig sa inyo. Paano niyo ini mahimo kontra sa amon? I mean, we've done this to cities, to nations. Diin kamo malagyo. Saligan nyo blang inyong hari. So here, we find na they are starting to terrorize the city with words. And by doing this, base pa lang ang ining city ma-crumble even without one shot. Waay sang isa kalupok, pero ilang nga nasubdued ining city. And yet we know how God delivered. How God delivered these people. Look at chapter 19, verses 35 and 36 in 1 Kings. In 1 Kings chapter 19, the same account na ginhatag diri sa aton, the Word of God would tell us on verses 2 Kings, 35 and 36. Ari ang ginhambal sa pulong sa Ginoo. And it came to pass that night that the angel of the Lord went out and smote in the camp of the Assyrians 185,000, 185,000. And when they rose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead corpses. So Sennacherib, king of Assyria, departed and went and returned and dwell at Nineveh. And it came to pass as he was worshipping in the house of Nisroch his god, that Adrammelech and Sharezer his son smote him with the sword, and he escaped into the land of Armenia, and Esarhaddon his son reigned in his stead. During the night, sang ang tanahan nagahulat na that probably the next day would be the last day. The next day would be the time that king of Assyria, Sennacherib, is going now to enter into the city, to capture the city. The angel of the Lord went out for them and annihilated 185,000 people. Now, you know, when you think about this, paano ina natabo? These are hardened. These are men who had been to war, but 185,000 of them were slaughtered by God. No wonder kun aton ini basahon bala na dinalan sang kasulatan nga aton nga ginatun-an kung diin ari ini ang ini nga bersikulo nga ginahuptan naton. Be still and know that I am God. Lantaw blood sa verse 5. God is in the midst of her. God is in the midst of her, talking about Jerusalem. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. early in the morning, waay gid na late ang Ginoo. Sa tiyon nga kinahanglanon nila, by the time they woke up, probably all of them couldn't even sleep at night, but all of a sudden there was hush, there was silence. In the early morning hours, no wonder 185,000 had been slaughtered by God. Kag ilay na nasapuan, kag nakita na nila the next day. No wonder here, when King Hezekiah was writing this song, starting on verse 1 up to verse 9, he was describing who God is, the presence of God. Nga ang presensya sa Ginoo, ari diriya sa aton. And yet on verse 10, this is the message. The message of God, both to the enemies and also to God's people. To cease fighting, cease striving. Surrender yourselves to God because God is going to fight for you. Mga kauturan, this had been long months for us fighting this unseen enemy. And how many times listening to the testimonies of those who ended up in the hospital or have probably had been struggling in their homes or in the quarantine facilities. O mga kauturan, mabatsyagan tagid that indeed ang presensya sa Ginoo nga sa tiun nga kinahanglanon siya, sa tiun nga amunag ni ang tiun tani nga doon delikado ng kabuhi. The help from God came. Look at verse 1. It says, God is a refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. So mga kauturan, diribla, if you are going to be still, if you are going to give up all our attempts in self-preservation, may God give us the wisdom when to strive, when to work, when to do our best, but when also to rest in the Lord, rest upon His promise. Just like the people there in Jerusalem, sang pakabati nila sa pulong sa Ginoo nga ginhambal ni Isaiah pakadto sa hari, kag ang hari nagtindog that God is on our side, God is going to protect us, we are going to be courageous. Men and women in Jerusalem rested themselves. They let go of all those worries, of all those fears, of all those doubts, of all those lingering thoughts, the overthinking. Kung ano ay han ang matabo, ano ay han ang ano, bao kung tani, bao inigitani. When they let go of that, ilang naintindihan kag nakit-an kung sino ang Diyos sa ilang nakabuhi. Nauna gid sa tanan, makita naton diri sa verse 10, naghambal dira, be still and know that I am God. Who is He? Sino bala siya sini? Nga chapter, nga sini nga ambahanon nga ginsulat ni Hezekiah. Una gid sa tanan, makita naton dira sa verse 1 that He is a refuge. He is a refuge. Panaguan, dalaganan. Now, I don't know. Labi na gid sa mga tion na daway na kita dalaganan. Labi na gid nga kun amo ang ato nang mismo nga pinsar panguna-una, amo ang nagapabugtaw sa aton the whole night. Where are we going to run for refuge? The Word of God says, be still. Magpakalinong ka. Stop striving. Stop running to and fro. Give it up. Release it. Let go of it. Surrender yourself to God. And you would know that He is a refuge. But secondly, not only that He is a refuge, but also He is our strength. Inibalang ginatawag nila nga pandemic fatigue. Na daw kadugay na, daw katalaka na, daw na lasayan ka na, daw anon lang ni Mando, sulit-sulit. Kung isa daw may kakusog, may kaisog, and then nakabati ka naman ng tabo, balik na naman, daw kaluya naman, daw nahadlok ka naman, na daw amo-amo lang ni, sulit-sulit na lang. Until it's already getting into our system, we are being tired of what's going on. Mga kauturan, I hope at this point of time, since this had already been a long pandemic, Kabay pa, hindi lang nakapangita kita sa panaguan, pailihan naton, kung diin kita makadalagan sa tiun nga may ara sa problema, kag may ara sa katalagman, kag mga makalukululba ng mga tiniun. We realize and we know that God is our refuge. And secondly, He is also our strength. Ini ang kusog, magalabot lang ini sa aton, kung aton man na intindihan, nga sa tion nga kita maluya. As what the Apostle Paul said, that when I am weak, then Christ, God, became my strength. Mga kauturan, ang tion gali isang kaluyahon, ang tion gali nga maubusan kita sang kusog, tion man gali ina, na ma-experiencehan kag ma-assertin naton ang kusog nga halin lang gid dira sa Ginoo. So I hope this morning when we contemplate on this, God, I know nga grabe ako nga sala-sala, Ginoo, I'm going to let go. Sang sini Ginoo nako nga mga paghimakas nga balaan ko gid nga maski anhon ko pawain na gid ako sini sing mahimo. So I'm going to release this to you. I'm going to cast this burden upon you. I'm going now to surrender sang akon niya nga mga kun anong akon nga kasarangdara sa imo. And I would let you do the fighting. And I would let you do the work because you are both my refuge but also my strength. But thirdly here, it says here, He is our help. Siya ang aton na bulig. Now, I don't know kung ano ayhan ang kasadya sang tagipusoon ni Hezekiah. I don't know kung ini ang ladies choir when they sing starting on verse 1. I don't know if their voice could be so loud and so excited that on the very night the Lord protected them and the Lord slaughtered their enemies. Amo na sa pagbugtaw nila sa pagkaaga. Indeed, He is the very present help. Not the late help. Not nga ba tani ko natabo ini nga amo sini. Tani o ay tani ini yan naglabot sa amon. Pero galing lang kay ulihi. The Word of God says that He is the very present help. Present help. Sa tion nga aton kinanglanon, magalabot sa aton ang ina nga bulig niya. Now I know I realize that some would say, Pastor, ano, how could you explain ang iban nga ginkuha sa Ginoo? Now, I want to tell you that this is the story, the whole story of the gospel. Na ang Ginoo nagkari kay ang ining lawas, malabot gid ini sa iyayang katapusan. Ining lawas, maglabot gid ni ang tiod nga kundiin, hindi niya na masarangan kung anuman nga masakit o kung anuman dira nga mga virus o kung bacteria nga amugin, ang mga guba sini. But Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. The rest we could find is the rest that He has prepared for us in heaven. But as long that God still has something for us, He is a refuge, He is our strength, He is a very present help. Sa sini nga pagkabuhi, sa sini nga panglugayawo naton, sa sini nga duta. But also, fourthly here, we see who God is. Lantawan nyo baladra sa starting on verse 7. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Selah. Come behold the works of the Lord, what desolations He had made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease and to the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear in sunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Grabe ang paghimo, kag siya lang gid sini ang makahimo. How could He do this? The cessation of war. Ginuntat niya. He is the only one that could bring peace. Na kung kisa ang peace nga ginapaminsar sang iban, tungod kay ginpasugtan lang naton. I mean, paano mo pasugtan ini ang COVID-19 virus? Paano mo ni mapasugtan ang mga butang that is either sila o kun ikaw? It's either there has to be victory or ill. Sa aton niya nga mga kabuhi, ikaw kag ako, kinahanglan gidya ang aton nga kadalagan ara lang sa Ginoo kag pinaagi sa sinang kadalagan naglabot ang kalinong. Mga kauturan, science, the world, everybody thought this is just another disease. So as long as may vaccine, as long as may bulong nga ginobras ang science, then mauntat ini. And then in summertime, in the last month or so dito sa US, nga nagsaka naman liwat because of this Delta variant, then na-realize nila nga maski ano sa kaalam o kung ano ayhan ang sa warp speed kadasig nila nga na nakapagwa sang vaccine, and then ari na naman. Now if we're going to study the word of God, both the scientist kag ang behavior sang sininga virus kag ang tanan nga ini, the way we look at this, there is only one that could ever give us victory over this pandemic. And we have to realize and we have to recognize that. Be still and recognize. We have to recognize that the only one that could do this is God Himself. Now I know, damo sa mga discussion subong, ti vaccinated man to siya, ti nga nalabuto siya sang kasubong sini. Now, since when? Sabi na kita ang mga Kristohano, naglabot. Nga it's either bulong o kung sino man dira nga among nagauyat sa aton kabuhi. We know that it's God. Pwede niya gamiton kung ano man dira. It could be the vaccine, it could be the way ang aton immune system maga fight out o kung ano man dira ang bulong nga gin-administer sa aton. But I want to tell you at the end of the day, He is the only one that could make, He maketh wars to cease and to the end of the earth. So mga kauturan, ang akon nga panghangkat sa inyo sa sining aga, I don't know if we have stopped. I know we're all praying. Ginoo ayuha, Ginoo labuta, Ginoo kabay pamahimunan. I don't know if we are still praying. God, if this is your will, would you stop this? Siya lang sining makauntat. Siya lang sini ang makasaway. Siya lang sini ang makahatag sa aton sa kung diin malabot naton ang aton niya nga mga kinahanglanon. Both sa health naton kag sang aton nga protection. May this morning we pledge again ourselves to the God who maketh wars to cease. This could be a real war nga ginatubang ni Hezekiah. Or this could be our unseen enemy, the unseen war that we are waging. Ang ato nga pagsalig, ara ng gihapon sa inya. Who is He? Who is He? Be still and know that I am God. Who is He? Sino ining Ginoo? He's our refuge, He's our strength, He's our help, He's our present help. But He is also the God who brings peace. But second, not only that we're looking at the person of God, but also look at the plan of God. In chapter 46, verse 10, be still and know that I am God, the person of God. But secondly, lantawan niyo bala dira, not only the person of God, but also look at His plan. I will be exalted among the nation. I will be exalted in the earth. Mga kauturan, iniba lang ang nagkalatabo, the same way nga natabo dito sa kay King Hezekiah sa time ni Isaiah, kung paano nga gin perdi sa Ginoo nga sila gani wa isang isa ka arrow nga napalupad, wa isang isa ka espada nga nagamit nila, and yet God maketh the wars to cease. In other words, as far as these people are concerned during this time, it was really the hand of God. Now, the way I look at it, kung ano magkalatabo, with all the vaccine, with all the science, with all of this, and with all of that, that all of a sudden, through His own plan, and through the prayers na ginapamatian niya halin sa aton, that God is going to stop this for His own purpose. Ano blang tinutuyo niya? Labi na gid ang pagdala sini, kagkabay pa aton mga tagipusoon subo, na punana sang kasubong sini. hindi lang sa paglaom that God, you're going to end this, pero ang ini naman nga nagkambyo ng panulok ta sa aton kabuhi, nga pwede man lang gali kita makalabot sa katapusan sa aton kabuhi, God giving me a chance again. Gamiton ko yung kabuhi ko sa pag-alagad, pagsunod sa iya, labi na gid sa pag-share sa iya nga pulong. Look at the plan of God. God is going to be exalted. He will be exalted in this pandemic. He will be exalted after the pandemic. So everything that is happening now in your life and in my life, at the end of the day, makita gid naton that this is the plan of God. This is the exaltation of His name. This is the glorification of His character. And this will be the recognition of who God is. I will be exalted among the nation. I will be exalted above the earth, among the earth. But also lastly here, it says here, lantawan niyo bala dira sa ano, verse 11, the Lord of hosts is with us. Makita tana sa verse 7, the Lord of hosts is with us. On verse 1, a very present help in time of trouble. On verse 5, God is in the midst of her, not only His person, His plan, but also we could see here His presence. I was talking sa isang akong diin kadamo gid, especially yung mga elderly na mga senior citizen na ang part sa ilang family. Nalabot, pilagid kabilog, including ang duha ka mga senior citizen. Manya pastor, we prayed to God, preparado na kami kung anong matabo, but you know, the Lord has gave us peace. Today, all of them survived. I think ang isa sa pinaka-anusin ni kay may mga ginapangayo, kita ginaangkod kit sa Ginoo, why bala natin na-release bala ini? Mamahatag natin ini sa Ginoo. Either ayan pag-ayo or either ayan nga ginkuha sa Ginoo that we could really give it to God. Ginoo, i-release ko ini nga mga balatyago. Isalig ko na lang, butang ko akong pagsalig dira sa imo. Because you are here. God is in the midst of her. The Lord of hosts is with us. Ang Ginoo, ari sa kaupod sa aton. O kabay pa, mga utod sa Ginoo. When we recite the verse again, be still and know that I am God. Nang Ginoo mo ang refuge nato, naton nga strength, ang aton nga kabulig, amo ang magdalasang peace. But also we know that we could be at peace, we could rest at night knowing the plan of God. The plan of God is not to hurt us, the plan of God that He's going to exalt Himself. And with this, we would be the worshipers. Kitaya mo ang magadayaw when we sing, nga amugal ini, Ginoo ang tinutuyo mo. Some of us had been hurt, some of us had been hit, some of us are in deep sorrow. But Lord, at the end of the day, this will be the exaltation of Your name. Praise be to You, our God. But also God, this is also the time na intindihan gid namo, You would never let go of us. Ari ka Ginoo upod sa amo. And this is our hope. This is our comfort. This is our encouragement. God with us. Magapangamuyo kita sa siningaga. Kagaton nga pagpangamuyo sa siningaga by using this psalm. I don't know if you have if you have done this before. Na bala nga gabasa ka sa pulong sa Ginoo labi na gid sa Psalms, and all of a sudden the psalm, the song or the songs became your prayer. Mga muyo kita sa sininga aga through this Psalm 46. Ginoo, salamat gid Ginoo na ikaw among amon nga refuge, ang amon nga strength, ang amon nga help. Ikaw ang Ginoo nagadala Ginoo sang kalinom. O Ginoo, how many times in our lives that we took the matter into our own hands, napunan kami isang salasala, napunan kami Ginoo nga kung diin, maski diin na lang kami, even Ginoo ang amon nga mga katulugo na dula na sa amon. But Lord, to no avail, because some of the things hindi mahimo ko, hindi mahimo sang tao, ikaw lang gid. Thank you, Lord, for inviting us to rest in You,
to release this burden in you, to surrender ourselves to you. Na kung ano man Ginoo ang inha nga mga ginahimo namon for self-preservation, Lord, we have already given it up to you. Lord, fight for us. Lord, work for us. You are the God. Na amo ni Ginoo ang imo nga plano nga sa tanan nga kasubong sini labi na gid sa mga kaanakan mo Ginoo. Ikaw Ginoo ang madayaw. Ang imo nga gahom, ang imo nga pag-ayo, ang imo nga comfort, ang imo Ginoo nga encouragement, especially those that some of us have already reached bottom. And yet, Lord, when we reach bottom, we realize that you are there. God is in the midst. The Lord of hosts is with us. Ginoo, ikaw lang makasaway sang sini Ginoo ang pandemic. O Ginoo, pamatii ang among Ginoo nga pangamuyo. Lord, hear our prayers. Unta ta ini Ginoo. Hatagi Ginoo sang kusog kabakod labi na gid ang nalabot sini. Ang mga dulaan sang miyembro sang pamilya Ginoo, labot ta sila Ginoo sang imo nga bugay that even they could never explain kung paano nila ini Ginoo nakaya na sarangan. It's all by your grace. It's all by your mercy. Lord, we're going to be still in our soul, to rest in you, to let go sang siniginoo nga mga pagpanikasog namon, to surrender our lives to you. Lord, you have instructed us to cast our burdens upon you because you care for us. Buligi kami Ginoo. I don't know Ginoo kung sa sining aga may ara man ayhan na nagapangita sang sini nga pagtinlo kag kaluwasan o kabay pa nga makita nila ini. Dira lang gid sa kay Jesus sa pag-angkon sa iya bilang personal nga manluluwas kag paghinulso Ginoo sang amon nga mga sala. Pakamayuha Ginoo imong pulong sa amon nga tunga. Buligi kami, tudloy kami Ginoo how to be still and to know you as our God. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
God has given us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Let us sing this song, Victory in Jesus. Ready? Sing.
I heard an old story, how a Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. I heard about his groaning, of his precious blood atoning. Then I repented of my sin and won the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me, I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about his healing, of his cleansing power revealing, how he made the lame to walk again and caused the blind to see. And then I cried, dear Jesus, come and heal your broken spirit. And somehow Jesus came and brought to me the victory. Oh, victory in Jesus, my Savior forever. Who sought me and bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew him, and all my love is to him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing flood. I heard about
heard about the streets of gold beyond the crystal sea, about the angels singing and the old redemption story. And some sweet day I'll sing up there the song of victory. My Savior forever. He sought me and bought me with His redeeming blood. He loved me ere I knew Him, and all my love is to Him. He plunged me to victory beneath the cleansing.
Padamugid nga salamat sa pagpamati ninyo sa pulong sa Diyos sa sining aga. Magpagamuyong kita. Amay nga balaan, langit mo namon nga Diyos, nagpasalamat din kami sining adlaw sa pagsimba Ginoo dira sa imo. Nagpasalamat kami nga itagaan nimo kami sa kahilwayan. Kusog ka kabakod nga makasimpa kami Ginoo dira sa imo online. Lord, pray namon sa imo na nagpasalamat kami sa mga kauturan nga nagsimba pud sa amon nga sa nakalain-lain nga lugar sa kalibutan kag sumuman sa Pilipinas. Nagkalipay kami sa pag pud sa imo Ginoo, salamat sa imong presensya nga nagahatag pagid sa amon sa kadasig Ginoo sa pagpangalagad dira sa imo. Nagpasalamat kami sa imong pulong, imong pulong buhi, ang imong pulong Ginoo nagatudlo sa amon, nagasabdong sa amon, nagagiya sa amon. Lord, ginapray namon nga hindi lamang nga manog pamati kami sa imong pulong, kundi maaplikar gid namon Ginoo sa amon nga kabuhi sa adlaw-adlaw nga tanan. Nagpasalamat kami kag itala kami liwat sa sunod nga semana Ginoo sa pagsimba dira sa imo. Lord, ginapray namon nga ikaw ang mag-upod sa among mga kaanak kanakan ni mong Ginoo sa sining iglesia. Nagpangayo kami nga ikaw ang magtupod sa ila, sa ila mga plangabuinan, kagkundiin man ni mo sila kinabutang Ginoo. Lord, thank you. Kagkabay nga ang gugmas ng Diyos na Amay, ang bukay ni Kristo Jesus, kikambit sa balaan niya Espiritu, mangin sa aton karon kag tutob sa gihapon. Amen.
Precious name.
was